Now it's time to start looking at the third method of programming, which is writing scripts. In QSIS, you can write script using the Lua language by adding any components to your schematic that has a Lua editor. There are a couple of components that have this. If you look in the Scripting Components branch, you'll see the Control Script and the Scriptable Controls component, both of which give you access to writing Lua. In newer versions of QSIS, you'll see the Text Controller component instead of Scriptable Controls, but they have nearly identical functionality, so we'll use them interchangeably in these videos. The difference between these is that Control Script provides input and output control pins for you to wire other components to your script, while the Scriptable Controls or Text Controller component allows you to add customized controls embedded within the component, which will be a little easier to reference internally. We'll look at creating these custom controls later, but for now, let's just do a tour of the scripting window. For the Control Script, simply double-click the component, and instead of a control panel, you'll be taken to the Script Editing tab. This is the big black screen in which you can type in any script you like, if you know what you're doing. From the Scriptable Controls component, you'll need to click this S icon in order to access the Script Editing tab. In the newer Text Controller, you can use the Edit button located in the same place. Within the Script Editing tab, there are a few areas to talk about, but first, I'm going to enter emulation mode. It's important to note that your script will be functional in emulation mode. If you're sending commands to third-party devices or adjusting behavior of your design, this does not require any audio processing, so you don't need to be running on an active core. Additionally, you can write your code in emulation mode or in run mode too. There's no need to return to design mode to work on it, the way you do with the structure of your audio architecture. As you type your script, you'll notice a large yellow bar at the top that says Save Changes. Until you press this button, the previous version of your script is still active and running. This lets you make changes to the script on a live core, but waits to deploy those changes until you've finished them. At the bottom of the screen, you'll see the debug output window. If there are any errors in your script, the debug window will identify what that error is and which line it occurs on. You can see the line numbers for your script listed down the left side of the editing window. When you start writing script, you may not always understand the errors the debug window describes, but hopefully it will at least point you in the right direction. You'll also notice that the top bar displays a list of the total errors in the script, as well as the current load your script has on the available processing power. You can also find these determinations over in the Design Inspector. Each scripting object that has errors will display as a red circle, while scripts that have no errors will display as green circles. Incidentally, you can also add Lua to a block controller by going to the System category and dragging in a Lua code block. If you just know you can script one particular thing faster than finding the blocks for it, or if you need to write a script for something the block controller can't do, but you still want to integrate it with your other block programming, this block's for you. And once again, if you're just jumping to this point in the control training videos, let's remind you one last time that if you are using any scripting objects, then you will also need to deploy a scripting engine feature license on your core before deploying. In the next few videos, we'll talk about some basic tools you'll need to write Lua script, and we'll also show you their equivalent concepts in the block controller and, if possible, the control components. So move on whenever you're ready.